This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so last class what we discussed. So starting as a so customizations, okay, and customization of SPRO. So SPRO, what are the options is available? Okay, in SPRO, what are the options is available? The next one is a NW, what are the options? Still is not complete, can continue second again. So but in SPRO, what are the options is available totally? So totally you have totally 7 tabs is available. So out of 7 tabs, so what are the tabs we discussed yesterday? First one is the general settings. So first we're discussing as a general settings. Okay, under general settings, what are the options is there you can discuss. After that, so you have to go for as a what is the next one? So shared master data settings. Okay. One is the common component setting. Okay, common component settings. So after that, one more is well, one more option again. I think gender setting, shared master data, common components. Right. Next one is the synchronization algorithm. Next one is the
maintain connection. Maintain no, connectors.
No, that is different. Under is committed common component.
Okay.
Within 7 tabs. Okay. After we have access controller is there and process control is there. Okay. So next one is the list management is there. Okay, these are the options. So yesterday, what are the settings you done yesterday?
General settings, shared.
General settings is then shared master data and I told that the most important point here common component settings. Again, under here, three settings is one of three settings. The first one is the create the connectors. Okay, create the connections with the connectors. Okay, and then again, what is the second option?
Maintain connectors,
maintain the connectors.
And connectivity.
Connection types. Okay. And next one is the
connector group.
Connector not group. Integration framework. That is available. Here only available the connector group.
Okay.
That is a integration automation. Okay. So all of this. So here I want to make a one-to-one connection with the connections. But you say here one concept is what is the concept? Connector group.
Groups.
Or is you can calling as a logical group. Two namings is there. Either you can call it a connector group, either you can call it as a logical group. So what is meaning of connector group is nothing, right? For example, I have ECC system is there. Okay, I have ECC system is there and GRC system is there. Actually, how to make a RFC connection between these two? So you have to make it as a yes. Means I want to make a RFC. First of all, what are the credentials is required? What are the details is required? Say what are the system details is required? GRC system, what are the system is required? So in this example, our training system GRC, what are the client number you have?
4473.
So in this one, this system is a 800. So how we make RFC? You have to make a logical system. What is the logical system of your this GRC? GRC CLNT 47. So here, again, what is this one? Your EH7 CLNT client number
800.
So the connections is okay. But I want to take the data for multiple clients. Suppose now I have 100 is available, okay. 200 is available, 300 is available, 400 is available. So I want to take the data from this overall to and push it to the GRC system. And what we do? So again, separate naming. Achyuta, mute invested just so you get some noise because recording is working. Yeah. CLNT 300 and that one 87 CLNT 400. Okay, these are, so I want, these are the all. Now what will I want to push this overall data into the GR system? Then what will do? At that time, what will do? So you have to making as a, this all as a one group. That group you can calling as a, what we call, you can call as a, this group you can calling as a connector group. RS you can calling as a logical group. So this logic, even you say these are called logical systems. Is logical representation of your, it means it's alias name of your client. So you have to just give this overall data and you automatically the data will be computed here. That is meaning of connector. Clear? You have to go for practical session, you have to clearly everything for. So because this is the most important for risk analysis, or you want to go for PRM error, this concept is most important. Okay, now coming to here. Okay, so now today our concept is you have to go for access controller. In access controller, what are the options is there? Will be go for one by one practical session. So till now, these four settings, are any queries? Jeevan and Akshita, any queries?
Yeah, I have. Okay. In that, where I have a conf in that main customize specific menu, is there, right? In that configure launchpad for menu.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, I have a thing. Actually, yesterday, lot of doubts are there, but I didn't get that video, so I'm not able to recollect the things, but I have to do one by one.
Okay, let me share this screen and show the doubts, what the doubts you have.
Here in the general setting there is an okay maintain customer specific menu, in that this is a NWBC configuration, right?
Yes.
So here all the, what are the line items, everything is configured in NWBC?
Yes.
Oh, so if I take any one GRC AC GRAC setup, okay?
Okay, double click on that.
Okay, this is a report to run. So
check it. Okay, so this is just the setup only, don't have running anything. This is for access maintenance and creating as a, just go for, if you want to add anything, you can add anything. You have to do any customizing, you can do that. This is adding and add. So already we added some folder, I think. AL.
Yeah. Last time we added one folder, right?
That is a workbox is there. No? Once you open the NWB, go back. It only
in home, we have added.
GRC underscore home.
Where we added?
First, GRC.
Yeah, that one.
Okay. Oh, here we added one.
Your name, with your name.
Yeah, my name is added. So okay. Related programs.
That is related application. What are the application?
We added. So we yes. Got it in that.
NWBC.
In NWBC screen.
Under the GRC.
Home.
No, home.
GRC home.
That is my home. These are the folders will be there.
So the setup and access management and all, where it is coming here?
There only, let's go with it. Go for NWBC. Naming will be there in a role setup.
No.
That naming is the role setup. Yeah, that is the role setup, normal setup, access management. The main naming is starting GRAC setup, GRAC access management, GRAC report and analysis.
GRAC okay. Setup. This access management is there, right?
Okay.
This access management, where it, in the back end it is configured.
Yes, go for the large integration one second.
Here. Where it is configured, that access management.
See there, no? Yeah, below second one only. There. G GRC access manager.
Oh, so this one is the okay. Yes. Okay. So whatever the role here we created, it will be coming as a tab. Right?
Yes.
It will come as a tab.
Yes.
Like that setup here, this is setup is there.
Yes.
I'm not able to find out the setup.
Scroll upside. There only the first letters only, there only there. Yeah. See the naming convention. Access controller setup worksheet. Description is there, no? You can find easy. Description. Third tab, you can find that. GRC access control setup worksheet. Third one. Fourth one, yes. Fourth one is the third one is for reporting. Fourth one is for access management worksheet. Okay, assessments, internal editing. GRC. Okay. Yeah, that's
but I have a lot of doubts. Okay, fine. You can carry out the next topic.
Okay, yeah. Now go for here only. Go for SPRO, go for next settings, right? Go for now. These four common settings is for everywhere. Here only. Just minimize this.
Yeah. Okay.
Then the settings will minimize it. Expand the GRC. Yeah, I have four. That is okay. And now we are to go for fifth option. The first four settings is common for everywhere. Now, I want to do the settings for only access.
Can you recap what are the things are there in the general master reporting and the common settings?
Okay, go for general settings once again. Under general setting, what are things? Customizing menu, language setup. Okay.
Yes.
So that we have accept that. Define the number ranges. Those only done.
Okay.
This MSAP workflow, you're doing the post-sensory system, you have to perform that. Workflow is there, no? Remaining is not touch anything, only workflow you can touch.
Okay, fine.
And you can go for shared master data. Shared master data, you have to maintain only organization. Create the root organization, maintain the organization. Third and fourth option.
Oh, we did it third and fourth. Create root organization hierarchy.
Yes, root organization, maintain root organization.
We did it.
Yeah, you done that also.
Oh, we did it.
We have done three and four options.
Part four and you done. Okay. Again, go back. Yes.
Yeah, this one we remember that. Yes, organization. Okay, then.
Yeah, reporting you don't do anything because you do remoting as automatic by itself. Remaining is no need to do anything. Remain don't touch anything.
Okay.
Okay, remaining reporting you don't. Next one, common component setting.
Expand the here's the integration connections.
Create RFC connections. Define the connector group and application types.
Okay.
Go back. And next one is the integration framework. Means what type of component you have to perform, you can do maintain the connection settings. Here you have to go for integration. You can close this. Project you are totally fine. Not accept customer. Okay, that is it.
So in the connections type, we have a lot of connections, right? We have to select if the connection is LDAP, we have to select the LDAP, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. LDAP
based on your backend. Okay, based on the backend, you want to maintain define the connector. Okay, connector settings.
Okay. So we have to select the LDAP and we have to define the connection. Then based on this thing, then we have to go further to that.
Everyone is going for HANA DB only. Because maybe your backend system also taking HANA DB.
Yeah.
You do integration also. GRC to HANA integration also you have to perform.
Okay.
Those are the common settings you done best. Now, today you have to go for as a access setting. Under most important is first option over there. Maintain the configuration settings. So means how your output is. For example here, so risk analysis is there. Under risk analysis by default is not available. So you have to add one by one. So how to add one by one is nothing but just click on new entries. Wait, what happened? Here only there, no need to go, just wait. First one only there.
Okay.
Yeah, under only see the first parameter group, we have what are the columns will be there here? Parameter group, parameter ID, parameter value, and parameter description is there. So So parameter group is nothing but what type of task you are to performing. I performing as a risk analysis, I have to perform as a access request management, I have to perform as a BRM, I have to perform here based on the your company, you can do the setting. Suppose just assume as a I have to perform the risk analysis. So risk analysis, what are tabs is, what are parameters is there here? Risk analysis under the parameter 1021. Okay, 1021, 1023, 1024, 1025. That, next one, next parameter ID. Parameter ID, okay, 1023, just all parameters. So what is this parameter? I don't understand what it is. Okay, so where are you getting this? This is nothing but perform the risk analysis. These settings should be there. 1023 is there. 1023 would have. Suppose 1023 is there. See the 1023. What is 1023? See the description. Default report. Report type for risk analysis. So till I'm not understanding. So means what type of report you want to perform the risk analysis? Here 01 is there. What is meaning of 01? I want to know that. So just click on browse option. Enter just browse. What is the meaning of 01? 0 is nothing but. So you want to preparing as a report for action level. Permission level, critical action level. Okay. How many settings is there totally by default?
18. So
totally 10 only there, but remaining is some guys are creating, like 21 remaining some guys are creating. Okay. Oh. So how to get explaining later that, so that is not our task. Okay. Fair. Now here, why you want to setting these settings? Because of these settings, you're determining your output. For example, close this, open the new session for NWBC. Sir, where are you getting these icons into the NWBC? Go for NWBC, go for access management. Just click on enable level. Just click on user level. Click on user level.
User level?
Yeah, above, not that, not the above, first one. User level. Yes. Now here, what is the checkbox is there here? What a checkbox is there? Access action risk level. Analysis. What a checkbox is there? Action level, critical action level, critical permission level. Why you having us only 5 options here? Why you 5 checkbox only there? Because here action level, permission level, critical action level, critical permission level and critical level. Why you have 5 only there? Because in backend you are putting as only 5 options. Check it, the 5 option. Go for backend system. Why the 5 checkbox only there? Because you're checking in, you have, you know, go for as a backend setting, the configuration setting, putting as only 5 settings. Here, 01, 02. Okay, next one, sorry, that is permission level. 03. Critical action level, 04, critical permission level, 05, just browse it. File. Okay, 06 is not available there. Check it, 06 is not available. Check it, 1 second. Because the checkbox is not providing there. Analytic reports. That is available, is not available. But 7th is the mitigation controller. Is there or not? That notice getting later when you do mitigation is getting not here, not that. So you're getting as a mitigation then. Okay. And now again here, invalid mitigation control, that is also not getting, that is doing as putting the report. So here the checkbox in are increasing. Yeah, that is difficult. Yeah, that is a mitigation purpose. I will explain that mitigation purpose. Okay. The 5 options, if you want to add the 6th option also, select the 6th parameter and just let the automatic is getting here. Yeah. Not yeah, click on new entries. Don't add like this. Select the parameter group, risk analysis, and the parameter ID. Project parameter ID 1023. Okay, now select the parameter value 06. And just click on enter button.
Save.
Save it. Click on OK. Now check it. Now go for NWP. Just click on refresh. Close and refresh again. Open one more time. Where is it? Is not getting there.
Not getting.
It's not getting. Where is it? Just click on mitigation analysis once again. Again, drop down list. Just click on drop down list. That is previously invalid. No, it's not getting. Maybe you check it once again. Where is it? Report that analytics. Go back once again. Scroll upside once again. Here, default report type is 06. 07 also there, remaining all options. We'll be checked, maybe we're taking some time when we're affecting. Okay. Yeah. Means now what type of tab, how to output you getting output, then we'll checking it there option only. Maybe that's a transfer. You have to create a new transport request is better. That's why maybe we're getting that. Open again once more, NWBC.
No.
Okay, we'll see later. Okay.
Okay.
So setting. Next setting. So next one again. Risk analysis also. What is the next one? Next one. What happened? Why are you closing your car? Okay. Now see here. What is the global row set? Is 1024. What is 1024 here? So default. Okay. What is display by default is there? 05 is there. What is meaning of 05? Again, just click on drop down list. So levels. So 05 is nothing but all risk will be getting. Again, we are getting once open NWBAC when you're running as risk analysis, just check it.
Can I open?
Yeah, open the NWBAC. When they open the NWBAC and check it. So what is the risk levels by default you're getting? Yeah, just click on user level. Yeah, now see here, risk level. By default, what option is there? Above 05. Okay, 05. So you have, suppose you're putting by default something, automatically screen by default. Okay, next one, rule set. What by default rule set is there? Global is there. Why is getting global? Because the settings only there. Check it, why the settings is there? What a parameter ID? Go there, just go for it. Okay, user type, dialogue. Okay, 1025. What is 1025 here? The global setting for global. Okay, that is by default getting global only. If you want to change anything, it change it. Okay, so. Like it's a standard basis setting. Okay, next one is the next one, user type. By default, A is the A is nothing but dialog user. Okay, there when you go for use risk analysis, check it. Okay, dialog users all. Okay, now check it. There also you're getting the same option. Okay, means here when backend system, what are the changes is the based on the you're getting the output. Okay, next one.
So how I know, this will be appear in that specific access management and user level access risk analysis, right? Okay.
You are setting the parameter group, na? Parameter, right? Based on the that is the practicals level only. When you do a lot of practical, then only can understand.
Yeah, understand.
Yeah. Okay. Standard settings, na? You don't want to do any customization.
So because here. The access management, risk analysis is coming here.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, suppose now you want to check the parameter group. Let's go for parameter group. Access management, every option is the next. Suppose now you're remaining all the enable the offline risk analysis, including that is what is scroll down. Suppose now I want to go for ARM. Scroll down ARM access request, scroll down below one. This is for risk analysis parameter IDs. So that is everything coming starting with 1000. Suppose starting to 4000. 4000 is nothing but say access management. But this is for emergency access management. Yeah. 4000, 4001, 4000, scroll upside. One by one, you have to go.
Oh.
Okay, the 4000, 4001, scroll up. Scroll up, yeah.
Yeah.
4000, 4001, 4000, around 4. Okay, the first one is the application type. Not that, that's okay. All 10 parameters is a can enable the DSS. Okay, application type. Okay, retrieve the send 30. Okay, what are the parameters you don't have? You can add manually one by one. Okay, just click on close this. Yeah, it means when you fire from gas EAM, you have to come to here. You can check it there. So, what is applications type? Application type, you have to fire from gas EAM for centralization. Either user level, you have to fire from centralization, either row level, fire from centralization. No, no, that is not available. This is for a firefighter. No, firefighters is not available that application type. Okay, just browse option once again. Only that logs is available. Log report, just browse option. So here you have two is either I want to making a centralization for ID base or I want to go for a role base. You have two, only two wheel is there. Okay, yeah, just go minimize. Yeah, like remain. So remaining now I want to go for ARM. So ARM, what are the parameters is there? ARM, BRM is also BRM, only three parameters, that is the 3000 above is there, na? Role management 3000 above 3000 above only there. Where is below scroller?
Ah,
above 3000 and below one is the access ARM. Okay, so these are the settings for that. Okay, yeah.
So for so next settings. So yeah. One doubt, we need to know all the parameters and the values also.
Means,
for role management. Meant we have to parameter.
Yeah, you want to remember that when you iterate point of you no need to remember everything, but when you do practical session for implementation level, you know all those things. Okay, because it's a mandatory setting.
But,
because
whenever we want to do some configuration, we need to.
Yes, only for implementation guys only this. No support guys are no need to this. Even support guys also. Oh. What type of reports you are, you know the parameter ID is compulsory.
Okay.
Can you give the can you give the for the 3000 ARM access role management the three things are there? Can you differentiate what the three things are there? Can you tell, because lot of things are there, we are not able to understand this thing.
Yes, actually.
Yeah, but because
you keep priorities.
Yeah,
tell me once again.
Yeah, there is lot of parameter ID is there, and
yes.
Their respective description is there. Even though there is a description, we are not able to understand this thing. On
because
reading
of,
the.
Once again, the clear. Okay. For example, let me show that now. Even if you're implementation, so what type of topic your implementation? For example, here topic wise, suppose now, so here I had to open the document for EAM. Okay, so EAM, so I want to centralization for EAM. So under centralization of EAM, what are the parameters first of all? So what are the post installation step? Let me see that. So everything is done. See, out of this, what are the parameter ID you can set up? Let me show this. It's not available here.
Stop. Okay, it's okay. What are the things? You know a lot of things, right? You can clarify with some examples.
But no problem. The topic wise, this is just I'm saying settings wise. Okay. So here is when you performing as any actions, they will be getting as a. So one second, that's what I'm showing. Like what? Suppose I want to go for BRM. One second, I will show that pre-implementation steps here. So see, what is this topic here? This is for
first
time when you're doing as a role creation means I want to perform the BRM. What are the settings? See, the first setting, what is the first setting? Maintain the connector group. That is a common setting. Okay. And the integration framework. I already told you, this is when you perform, you should be compulsory, you know this. After that, so what are the basis set you have to activate it? See, what are the basis set you are activating? Already discussed this. Why
yes,
is coming And again, coming to here, what are the default connectors is there? See, what are the parameters is there? Any parameter starting with 3000 to 3021, that is coming to the management. So those parameters you can define one by one here. Clear? When you're doing the practical session, you can understand for this. So I'm just say what is meaning of AXC configuration thing is how the output will be. This is for what is this? This is for BRM. This is a SAP only based on that you can change it. This is the BRM. For example, same thing I want to go for ARM also. So ARM, what are the post installation? What have been? So pre-implement for post installation of access requirement is what are the parameter? Again, see this is the common settings. The first of all, configure the parameters only. Again, here, what are the parameters is there? So when you go for topic wise, you can understand clearly for that. What are the parameters they activate for? EIRM. What are the topic for BRM? Same thing. When you go for as ARA, I already know that just now. And EAM. Oh, where is that EAM documentation? Yes, when you go for topic wise, you can know what are the parameters important, which parameters is default, you not activated that. Okay, at that time, we can discuss clearly for in-depth level. For just you can say how output will be designing. That is, you are demanding a very output configuration settings.
Yeah. You can share this yesterday document and today document.
I did not receive any document till now. Yeah, actually, you have to send to Chaitanya. Actually, a document I'm sharing you and a video recording, you can get the Chaitanya one because I don't get a meeting your email IDs.
Yesterday I called him. They are facing some issues. He told consolidate with three classes. He will send. He told.
Okay, last three classes will be there.
Okay.
Let me check one second videos. Okay.
I'll check with him. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Now share the screen again. Now what we do just with settings, what are the settings we want to know, just knowledge purpose only. Okay, yeah, then go back. Means based on the topic again, you have to learning for this because you don't know what is the ERM, like just normal I'm saying. Okay, what are the icons will we go for this? Next one is the maintain the connector setting. Sir, already you have to maintain the connection set for your access. Okay, so again here, see that what are discussing here. Target connector, application type, environment means where you're using, either using the development purpose, either using as a quality purpose, either using the production system. You have to mention that can't. Target connector is nothing but your backend system detail, application, that is SAP system only, and production, just browsing. What is meaning one is nothing but SAP system.
Okay.
In common component setting, what are the options? Same settings here, but here you're doing an access controller connector setting. And now you're using the development purpose. Explain the environment. This is for development or production or testing purpose. Okay, clear. Okay, then go back. Next one, maintain the mapping actions. That is done. No, that is not required. Attributes is not required. Okay, next one, maintain the mapping actions for connector group. Where you define the connector group?
In general settings.
In general settings or not? Common settings, you have to put in the connector. Under assign some applications here. Okay, so select your connector group. Suppose now scroll down, what is standard connector groups is there? Scroll down. What is the standard connector group is there? So you're assigning, scroll up, say, where is this? SAP R by 3 log on group, SAP basis this, okay? Select that group and just click on assign the default connector. Sir, like lot of connectors is, I want to making as a, my connection is a default. Just click on, yeah. Assign the default connector to this. Okay, so here suppose just click on new button, just click on new entries. Just click on new entries. So select your target connector group, SAP basis LG. Browse it. You don't type it, just browse it. SAP basis LG. That is my logon. But by using this logon, what are type? What are the purpose you doing? Four active. What are four active you have perform? You have to perform guys role generation. What do you mean the role generation? That is a BRM. 002. What is 002 here? Risk analysis. Yeah. 003 is nothing but which is authorization management, ARM. 004 is nothing but processing. 005 HR, that is HR data. Means first four I have to perform it. These are the actions I want to perform. That is the meaning of maintain the, so mapping the actions to your connector group. Means your backends, by using your backends, totally four operation. You can add four one by one. First one by one action. And target connector means your backend system connection details. What is your backend system? That by default is getting that. Yes. Where are you getting? How is getting by default? Why? Component settings, you are integrated this, automatically getting these connections. Okay, now I want to make it as a default. Check the checkbox is default. Means I want to make anything. By default, my connection group only getting and my target connection only will be getting one by one. Four you can add. So, yeah, I want to check the checkbox. That is a, yeah, default. Means I'm doing anything. Either I want 5.001, that is a risk analysis, role analysis, anything. My connection is the default. Then click on save button. That's it. That is the meaning of mapping the actions to your connector. Already is there, that's why it's sleeping. Just click on cancel. Okay, so means that is the option. Just go back. That's it. See,
then
a lot of the default will be there.
Assign group field man.
Yeah, already is there. Assign the field and parameter, no need required. Because you have to perform multiple pieces, no need for that. Only this two is important. That is the meaning of next way. And go back here. Yeah. So meaning only there, just here. Maintain the mapping for actions to your connector view. Already I have to create my connector view. Under connector view, I want to assign some actions. Actions is nothing but even role analysis, those type of options. Okay. Next options.
So which one is the default thing here? Everything is created by the participant.
Yeah, in real time only one is there, but you have the training system, no? Multiple invited.
Yeah. Okay.
In real time only one or two will be there. Okay, not everything.
Standard one, SAP basis, SAP R3 LG, like that, right?
Yeah, remaining what are the pieces that is there? Those are the in real time. Okay, and here the training, na, light up guys are creating. You also creating lot of when you do practice. Again, maintain the plugin settings. Means if you want to activate the plugins, and then you have to assign the target group and just click on in backend system. Which is our backend system here? EH7 CLNT 800. I want to deactivate that connection. Just click on select the target tube. Just click on inactive. Automatically the connection settings is that is very inactive. That is here inactive for your plugin system. Only to be just I'm saying inactive for. This is for your SAP system. You are inactive. Suppose my backend system is LDAP or HANA DB or Oracle database. Below it is there, right side. Activate the non. Activate the non plugin. This is again here application type and click on new entries. Active or deactivated. First of all, you have to create a target. Okay. Browse it. It's getting overall application. What is your backend system? My backend is enterprise portal. My backend is Oracle database. And you have to just click on that and activate it. And begin again. This is the activation. This is the activation funnel. Okay. Activation. Again, click on select the below one is there. Activate the non-plugin with IDs. Just select that connection. Just click on that. Okay, deactivate the existing ECC system and activating his new connections here. It's not done already.
I'm not able to understand this thing. First, you are deactivating the SAP system, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, but our SAP system is EH7 CLNT 800, right?
Yes.
Click it, it will be deactivated. The plugin is deactivated.
The RFC connection needed. Yes, the connection is breaking.
Okay, why we are breaking that?
Why? Because when you go for the EAM concept, what concept is there? Centralization concept and decentralization concept is there.
Okay.
Okay, there you can using this concept. Suppose this assume as in my company, what happened? Now we are making as a backend is the like my backend system is ECC. Unfortunately, my backend system is not. Unfortunately, you're not using as a. My overall user data is maintained like HR system, or LDAP servers, some IDM management. Then what we'll do? I want to deactivate existing system. I want to activate.
Oh, then we are going for some other systems.
Yeah. So just click on non. That is meaning non. Yeah, click on that. So uncheck that. So first of all, I'll check the any connection details. Then only can. Select any connected. First of all, connected details. Select any connected details.
Okay.
After that, just activate that. Under the connection details, you can activate that. Okay. Which application you activated and what is the activation is there. Means based on the situation. Now, my connection. Suppose the connection is just assume as it. The target connector is your LDAP phone. Activate that. It doesn't mention that. Yes. Okay, then click on activate. Okay, that is a SAP non-GRC plugin. Non-GRC is nothing is a IDM, SAP, HANA, DB, these all are non-GRC. And again, application again. Activate the non-GRC IDs. Select that and just click on again. Select that connection, application type, application type. Here in SAP, first of all, you have to select the right side, then only you have to go for left side. Select your entire thing. Select it. First of all, select it.
It's not selecting.
Okay, just go back. Now select it. Now click on non. Now click on yes. So you have to get the plugin adapters. I think you have to remember that when you connect it with the IDM, what is the connection you have to be with the adapters only. You have to remember the architecture, I think.
What is the difference of this thing? Activate non GRC plugin or non GRC plugin IDs.
IDs. Adapter connection details.
Okay. You have to give the adapter connection here.
Yes.
In the new entries.
So here is the user adapter, role authorization, profile authorization, those details. And click on activate it.
What are the things you need? You can activate here. And save.
Then go back. No need to do any deactivation because you're using only his backend system only.
Yeah.
Yet the connections it just is not wrong. It's wrong only. Uncheck it. Yes. The option is there. Okay. Yeah. If you want a decentralization of your backend system, you can go for. Okay. Next one. Distributed jobs for parallel processing. means I want to find a risk analysis taking as longer time. I want reducing the load balancing using this concept. We're applying server, server name, logon group, number of tasks, and number of jobs for the particular work process. So you're distributing for parallel processing. Parallel processing is a multiple processing. Means same task is performed by the multiple core. Suppose you have single core is there, dual core is there. What is the purpose of single core and dual core? What is the difference between that?
Multitasking.
Multitask, single task and multitask. So this is for multitasking. Okay, parallel processing. Okay, then go. But you don't have any, no need to do anything. Because this is due by the basis consultant, not for us. Because you have to create the log.
Yes, the logon group and everything is there.
No need to do anything. So he's asking that, okay? Next one, maintain the access risk analysis. This is what risk level, high level, medium level. This is by default. Just click on new address, you can add it. So by default, this is standard.
Yeah, how do you know this level code?
Yeah, click on new entries, automatically is getting. Just click on new entries. Just risk level, okay, okay. Don't know that. Okay, just leave it. You don't know that anymore. You have to Google it. Just leave it. Color coding, you don't know that. You don't know risk level color coding. You can go for Google only, can search it. What is the color code for high level, medium level? You don't know anything. Just.
Oh, color code.
Yeah, color code. Because you don't know the like, MS Paint, you don't know that color code. What is the color code?
Yes. Understood. Yes, every color have some number, right?
Oh. Yeah, color code.
Yeah, you don't know that.
Fine.
This is putting this.
We can take this is the default one.
These are the default codes. Next one, business process and sub-business process. Miss that? Yeah. Okay. Next one. No. Above one. Maintain the business process and sub-business. Miss modules and sub-modules. So when you're creating as a any risk. Or any BRM like any rows is asking where you creating which department. Suppose I want to create a basis department. So that is the basis is the business process. GRC language you can calling as modules. Sub business processes under basis task. Again, what are the tasks he is performing? Like he's doing the client administration, he's doing his installation, he's doing as a support package. This is called a sub business process. Okay, these are the this is the business process is nothing but is a module list. Okay, sub business process is the what are the tasks he is performing. Okay, suppose our business process is select the business process. This is optional, so you have to create your own business. Already standard business process also there. What is standard business process? APO, basis, and SA, SPO. That standard is then those are. CA-A00, CRM. Sir, where you using this is nothing but once open the new session, go for NWBC. So where you using most, this is the most important for access risk or BRM anywhere. Already open multiple, NWBC already open. No? Go for access management. Setup. So now I want to creating as a functions access. Yeah, go for access risk. Rule set functions is there. Go for access risk.
Last one.
Yes. Yeah, click on the create button. Now I want to create a risk. See here is asking as a business process. There's a drop down list. Select the drop down list. No need to do anything. A business process. Business process. Yeah, now see here what a business is all. Okay. So here how to create a business process where we're creating in backend only. When you back end,
so what are the things are in the backend, it is reflecting in the NWBC front end.
Yes.
This is a business.
So you had situation. Yeah. Not only this, even you have to go for as a BRM also. This is one year. business process is important because of where you create the risk. Either you have to go for which module means. Okay, close this. This is the one screen you're using. Okay. And go for the access manager. Okay, now we have to go for access request creation. Below any, then
at left right side.
Access request creation. Yes. Click on that.
Access for request.
Yeah, that is only just click on. This is for access request. Means I want to create a new account, change account. Yesterday you are performing now. Like here also, actually, here is not getting. Here also, maybe some guys are customizing. Here also asking as a where we create that user ID. For example, request for others, select the request for others. Maybe the options is getting. Request for others. Selfie is done. Just click on drop down list. Not getting it.
They are not getting any business process.
That is a business process. Which module you are creating as a user ID? But it's not creating, maybe somebody has. This is one thing. Okay, here also you're getting as a business process. Again, go for BRM. Closes. It's not getting, just click on closes. Means in real time, here also getting, remember that. Okay, next one, role management. I said, yeah, role maintenance is there. So here also you are selecting as a business. Click on create any role. Single role or customizing role. Okay, now here business process, sub business process. Business process, sub business process. And when you select the business process, then only you get a sub business process. So that's okay.
Okay.
Yes. These are the options.
So this both the things are to be created here.
Yes, we're detecting here. Business.
So where I have the sub business process.
Oh. Select that and right side you have it.
Yes, got it.
Yeah.
Two things are there. Yeah.
Assign application.
Sorry? No, that is not required because if you are assigning is nothing but you have the only particular group. No need for that. It's optional.
Okay.
That will assign you a connector, only one. Suppose you don't specify is multiple time, multiple process, you can assign it. Okay. I can go for next setting. Let's go back here. Let's go back. Next one. Maintain the actions for BRM. You don't go for this. Wait, we discussed that it is BRM plus. Next one, maintain the data source configuration. So where you take the source? So here, I can see here, this is for end user purpose. Okay, so end user purpose, you mean is where the user ID is here, user search data source, and your target connector, and your sequence number. Where are you getting this overall data? Last one is important. Where are you getting the overall user data? SU01. Or else where you take the data? You can take that from your HR data also. Click on new entries. Means you have to select your data source. Okay, select the target connector. So take anything, just any examples. Sequence number 05.
Sir, how we are getting some PN? There is some sequence, right? From 3 to.
Already
it's zero already to there. Yeah? Up to 04 is there, I think so.
Yes.
That's why you're taking 07. Yeah. What is there? Now I'm taking a zero.
Okay.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can take it from 6 also.
Now you did it and do it again. No, user data. This is important. Where are you taking your data? Either SU0 or either HR. Suppose my user data I made in HR system, then you can take HR. My overall users are made in SU0, then you can take SU. This is it. You want to maintain your data source. Okay, where you're taking your data, that's enough.
Yeah,
okay.
Here
yeah.
HR means it might be coming from LDAP server.
No, not LDAP. HR data, HR security.
Okay, SAP HR related data.
Yes. So you have to maintain your role registration into the HR system, not for ECC system.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Sir, in the sense that the user is raising a request, the user details will be extracted as per the HR data.
Yeah, no, sorry, come again.
When user is raising an access request, so the details of the user will be extracted from HR data, right?
Yes, exactly. Means okay. You take this request, so that's when we take it.
The HR data is not the ECC6 server.
No, it's not easy. HR is separately. So ECC, suppose in security point of view, ECC security is only for transaction code based security. When you go for HR security, it's position based security. So that both are security, even BA security is different. Okay, that is not coming to the separate. You have to maintain the, for example, best example, in real time. So what is the difference between the ECC security and HR security is nothing but, suppose my user IDs are maintained SU01, at the time what happened? Your employee ID, personal employee ID, means you are joining to company, you get one ID card. The employee ID, your SAP logon details, both are different. Okay, this is a two. That is means your ECC system is different, your employee data is different.
Yes.
Suppose my data and your SAP application both are same, means you're using as a HR system. Your data is maintained by HR.
So like that HR system, SRM, CRM security is different, right?
Yes.
Like enterprise portal system.
Yeah, that everything is different.
Yeah. So like that, you can have other thing also here, right?
Yeah, here only, but no, you're taking as a character only two, no? That's where HR has started.
Okay. If
you want customization, you have to contact the MAP department only.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Okay, yeah, go back again. Yeah, go back.
This is not selecting any.
Not required. It is for end user perspective, end user verification. Okay, end user data, same thing. Again, last one is the end user verification. You do end user verification or not? So you don't need to require authentication only. Only data source configuration you can do that. Okay, maintain the customer group, user group. So already this is same thing is if like a SUGR only. In SUGR you have to create the group, same thing here also you can create one group. Sir, we are using this is nothing but is the optional. Means group wise I want to perform risk analysis. Once go for ARA.
Okay, user risk analysis.
For
NWBC ARA.
Go for ARA under from the user level, just click on user level. Okay, now I want to perform it as a group level risk. Then you can use it as a custom group.
Maintain the custom group.
Yes. And under the group, you can add the user ID. Same thing is looking like a SUGR only. See here, user group is this. Right side is there, no? User group and custom group. The user group and custom group become GIS is taken by like friends. Okay. This is the user group. You're searching SUGR. Go for custom group and search the custom group. Click on search button. So it's getting it. Okay, you have two groups only there. Under groups, you have the users.
Okay.
Back in and check in. What are the users available that particular group? And you have to perform the risk analysis. No need. Click on search. This is the user group. 36 groups is there. SUGL, what we're creating this. Total how many groups is it? 32, 36.
36.
But you don't know what is.
Okay.
Go for back end now. Select it, right? See the user ID is now. They're only assigning that. Let's go back, go back, go back.
Custom groups.
So select the group name and check it. What are the user IDs? You have to add it manually. Select group and just right side is then maintain the users for this customer. So these are all user IDs. Okay, you have to add, just click on your this. You can add the user group there, user ID there.
Sir, we can create another custom group.
Yeah. That is a custom. Not all, this is the some guys are creating, that is also some guys are, this is not standard, there is no group. You can click on okay. New group and yeah.
We can
there is no okay. Standard, it's optional only.
Okay.
So GRC, everything you have to customize, you know, everything options. Okay, but real time, nobody touching as a customization. Okay. Because it's very complicated for everything you want to know, all icons and demon. Browse option, just click on browse option. GRC, but your user is not there, I think, just browse option. Browse option, F4, just click on F4. F4, remove that, just putting as F4. Something is putting a star. Example is saying just putting a star. A star.
Oh, 3000 entries.
Your user ID is there creating the server. Your user ID? It's not getting.
Star.
You have to remove the 5000. You have to remove the 5000. Then all is getting. Yeah. Remove the 500. Remove 500 is eliminated. Remove the maximum.
Maximum number of hits.
Remove the 500. Remove the 500.
Next tab. Next tab.
Yeah. Remove that 500. Then click on OK. She's saying 5000. And the 5000 also is not getting. Again, just maximum the drop down is. Remove the taking at the 550,000 and putting at the maximum. One more zero. Not taking.
Give all lines or else.
Okay. No, it's only 5,000 only. Save it.
Maintain user group. Okay.
And then go for just check it.
Refresh and we can check there.
Close the sessions because already say maximum sessions are reached. Open NWPC and check it.
Back to go?
User level. Browse option, custom group, not user group. Custom group. You can search.
GRC temp.
And one only one user.
Okay.
next option.
What is that? Master. Okay, this is the common setting. For again, four components. What are the four components? Like risk analysis and role management, user provisioning, and emergency access management. This is the common settings for these four components. Okay, now again, okay. Emergency access management. Again, what options is there? Expand EAM. Again, two options. Also, most important, synchronizing jobs. Just click on synchronize the jobs. So you have to synchronize the data from back end to front end. First of all, authorization synchronization. Just click on authorization synchronization. In PFCC, what type of authorization is just? You have to want that data you're synchronizing. No need to do anything. There's no need to sync, just assuring. Okay. Add the connected detail, backend connection, just click on execution button. Suppose I have to go for other than SAP system. That is called as a it's non-SAP system, you want to synchronize, you can add. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Now go back. This is the authorization data. Only authorization data. Now I want to synchronize the users, roles, profile, then you go for repository. Repository using diary. So roles here, what is the to synchronization? Checkbox is there. What is checkbox is there? Profile synchronization, role synchronization, user synchronization, role synchronization. Again, here two radio buttons. What is two radio buttons? Incremental and full synchronization. What is the difference between the incremental full synchronization? Incremental is nothing, but what are the first changes? For example, today I'm doing any changes. Only the changes is we want to do synchronization, you can use incremental.
Okay.
Onwards. Okay. So starting onwards, what are the settings you can do? Everything is synchronization.
So day by day, what are the incremental? Everything is collected by the this
incremental.
This incremental, this yes. The synchronization yes. Will do that, right?
Yes.
It's like a backup. It's like a backup. What we are taking incremental yeah. Differentiation.
Incremental backup, full backup. That's
yeah, it's like yes. That.
Yes.
Again, synchronized data like a legacy systems are the same thing.
Super. Okay.
And again, go back. Again, it should action is only transaction code your synchronization. Action you say is in a GRC language, actions you can calling as a transaction codes. Okay, so I want to enter the particular transaction, particular user ID and a particular target server. I want to collect that. So this particular user ID, what are the transition code is what are synchronization? Action is nothing but a transition code. Remember that. Okay, so you're already there. Using for the job is the never say that field name is then see that selection the data for transition uses. So you have to select the target connector and the backend system. Anyone user ID is there, you can select anyone user ID from there. Any user ID, you don't know, you have to type it user ID manually and there's a sticker that what are the transitions for everything is synchronized here. No need to.
Okay, I'm not going to execute. So connector to this thing means
multiple connectors also you can select it. Not only one, multiple connectors. So in backend system I have multiple connectors is there. So I want to take multiple connection. I want the single connection data, you can select the from and to value. Everywhere is there here, not only here, everywhere is there from and to value. Which two actually have everything options.
Now it's syncing the transaction from which connector to which connector.
Here both are same connector.
We have
only. here the different client you're taking means in 800, I have multiple connections, 800, 200, 300. I had to give the value. So I want to synchronize from 200 to 800. So in between, I have four client. I want to synchronize the overall client data. Then you can give the from and to value. It's the range, in between range.
Okay. Then what about the user?
Users are, so you don't putting users, but you don't know users now. What are the users is there? So you
so only connectors, different clients is enough, right?
Yes.
Okay. Hello.
Yeah, I'm there. Sorry, internet loss. Okay, next one. Role it says synchronization. Okay, what are the roles you want to synchronize it? Okay, again connector groups. Again from and to. Again, any event connector group only there.
Okay.
Okay, next one. Again, EAM, that is very EAM concept is the EAM, emergency access management.
Emergency access management.
You have to log on the backend system only, na? That's why you have to EAM log. Again, connector group.
Can I run?
No, don't do it. When you go for EAM, you can do that, no issues. Survey hangover. Again, firefighter for workload board, fetching the IDMs. Everything is synchronization process. So entirely using second option, that is a repository object data synchronization. That's enough. The remaining option is like discuss that.
Option are only the, it is asking for the connector only.
We need a connector, so you have to synchronize where to end.
Okay.
Sir, every day we need to do this thing. I mean, it is a mandatory job.
Not mandatory job. Actually, you can schedule in background also. No need to do daily because you want running background mode. So you have to, when you're scheduling background mode, just you want daily running, weekly running, monthly running. You can, means as a GRC consultant, when you're preparing as editing logs and I want to check in daily, then you have to run this compulsory. So how to make his automation is nothing but once select anything, yeah. Above main menu program is there, na? Select the program. Yeah, execute background.
Schedule in background.
Okay. Connector. They are running daily, maximum running daily only. But it's doing automation, not manually. Okay, go for main menu program. Execute in background. So he's asking as a what an output device. Click on OK. Why is getting printing this? Okay, select any output device. It's getting printing. Click on OK, anything. Printer is not available. Exhibit in background. Okay, you're printing, I think. Exhibit in background. Why is printing? Okay, select any file like. LP01. LP01. Click on OK. He's asking the server details. Okay, click on OK. Yes, now he's asking. So now you want to immediate. So daily, okay, just click on immediate. So periodic job. Check the checkbook is periodic. Periodic. First of all, check the checkbook. Then only can do that. Daily or hourly basis. No. 1 second. Before that, just click on. He's not checking. Click on checkbox. It's a period. Periodic. Now I want running daily. Daily about daily option. Yeah, click on check and save it. Now click on check and save it. Now what happened? Every day this app is running. No need to do every day. Logs automatically getting. This is for you making as automation. So see what is the background job is there. This is your stand transition code also. Suppose you want to type this transition code automatically getting. Open a new session. No. 1 second. Open a new session and type this that program. GRAC, okay, ST38 you are running, RSC you are directly running. GRAC underscore SP underscore synchronization. Run that. GRAC. No, directly run it 1 second. Maybe it is, your system is supporting on that. Okay, run it that. GRAC underscore SPM underscore sync. underscore sig. Yeah, it's there. Okay, click on execution button. It's showing is a dialog, we're showing the URL. Again, you're asking connect, same thing. Okay, again, go back. You can directly type the transition code. Directly type the transition. GRAC, type it. GRAC underscore SP underscore synchronize. Missing. Yes. Click on OK. Yes. Okay. Now directly is it. Okay. You know, try your. So it's very difficult to remember that.
That is a T code or program name?
Is a program name, is a report name, and transaction code, everything.
Yeah. It is working as a transaction and also reports, right?
Yeah. It's reported. It's a report. Now it's working. Same thing. All authorizations will be on that one. Suppose, like, again, A. So every synchronization jobs, yeah. So that is the overall synchronization. Okay. And next one, SOD, that is EAM, that is only master data. Next one, SOD organization values. Again, back end, what are the rule sets we are creating that values? Okay, now go for access risk analysis. Once expanded, access risk analysis. Again, generate the SOD rule. Suppose I want expanded SOD rules. I want a downloading. I want uploading manually. This is very, very difficult. Downloading the SOD rules, uploading the SOD rules, additional rules, generate the SOD rules, transportation, everything you can do that. Okay, batch risk analysis, multiple I want running background. So you can go for downloading the book for practical session. Okay. No need to do this. You're taking a lot of time. It's getting exercise. I'll explain it in all future. Okay. Access risk analysis settings you can perform here. Okay, next one. Workflow access risk analysis. Workflow that is discussed. That is for MSMP workflow. No need to do that. Batch. Yeah. Batch executing at a time. If I'm doing as excluding object for batch risk analysis, okay, what are the objects that excluding? Okay, so SAP underscore the profile. I'm not doing so SAP all is nothing but already is a critical the risk only. That's to excluding that. What are the objects? Is it okay? This will be discussing in access risk analysis. What is this? Means excluding is nothing but I'm not able to perform the risk analysis for those set, those objects. Either oh. User.
Either profile.
Yeah, profile. Role. These are two for three. These are the three levels you can do that. But HR also there, but is that is different. HR is also there. Means access risk analysis totally four types is the user level, profile level, role level, HR object level. So I want to restrict this. This profile name I not perform the risk analysis. So what a profile is there here? The profile is the SAP underscore all. I've not provided any risk analysis. So now I am putting this way. Yes, you can putting as a like what is they making? Excluding your passwords is there, no? Illegal. You can say illegal passwords. Like same again. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Then go back.
Here the user GRC-101 object is excluded, right?
Is that so particular user ID? Yeah.
Somebody is entered and its status is not activated.
Yes, means it's right? Not adding. Yeah.
Okay.
Means so, that guy is not performing any risk analysis.
Okay. So SAP on SAP new is out of exactly. The
No, no, once go for that ARA constant, one second, NWBC ARA, go for profile name. Profile level option is there, no? Now enter the profile. Now SAP underscore all, the profile is excluding. Okay, type it SAP underscore all. The system, enter the system and profile name. Those you not perform, just click on enter and give the system details also. System name. This is the object I'm excluding. System details I had to provide. Project, what is system you are excluding? What is the system those are given? No, naming is different. The first one, GRC-ECC is there. No, not that. That is only name. Check it once again. No, check it. Even IS non-test, check it. Yeah, that is only a check. No. Check it. Go for backend and check it. What system does that excluding? And already open, na? The copy and paste is better.
The same thing, right? Our AHP 7 client 800.
A small mistake also there, the connection is not there, no? That's why.
Oh.
Click on run it. No need to, just click on run it. Time in foreground. So those values, we don't getting any risk analysis. That is the meaning that. Violation, no rules are selected, nothing is there. So this was discussed loud. Okay, we'll go for the
action is no rule were selected.
Okay. I think access ID nothing is getting. That is excluding.
Okay. If instead of this SAP all, if you are selecting some other role, we will get a lot of risk or rule ID, yes, some SOD object. Okay.
Yes, everything is good. Yeah.
Okay.
Again, go back there, SPRO.
Yes.
That's okay. Clear. Close this. Now go for. Remaining is monitoring and batch analysis. That is only you want to run in the background job, batch sessions, executing the batch risk analysis, monitoring the batch risk analysis. Same thing. Instead of you have to go for foreground background, here also you can perform. Same name will be there. Yes. Now, first of all, you have to select the overall details. No need to take because it's taking time.
Okay, I won't. Just unselecting.
Monitoring purpose, again monitoring also same thing. What is job name? You are executing after the you are monitoring. What is the batch mode? Just now you are executing the batch name, batch over you can select it.
Yes, see, I believe you become very tired, so we can continue on next day.
Okay, no problem. It's okay. Yeah. Okay. Fine. Bye. We'll be continuing tomorrow. Bye.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.